Cabas and Dean Lucan. But the last time we actually won a medal in any sort of medal in Olympic weightlifting was at Helsinki in 1952, and that was a bronze. So trying to improve that record today was Robert Cabas. We join him in the 82.5 kilogram class. It's the clean and jerk section, and he's lying third. Your commentators are Wally Foreman and Bob Edmund.
Robert Cabas from Australia. And they're backing off in the fight for the bronze medal. Burrows of Great Britain has just injured himself and has bowed out of the competition, as has Lagrateria of Italy, who won't lift at all in the clean and jerk. So Cabas has the bronze medal. But Cabas will be more determined than that. He'll be looking for a silver medal. He's challenging Isayoka of Japan for the silver medal now. This is his second lift in the clean and jerk. If he's successful here, it'll put him 2.5 kilos up on Isayoka.
This is also a new Australian record, by the way. The old record is held by Robert at 191 kilograms. This is 192.5.
This has been a sensational performance by Robert Cabas. He's chosen his weights carefully. It's been a battle of strength as well as a battle of tactics here. And Cabas is winning on both fronts at the moment.
Oh, great lift! Tremendous,
a sensational
stuff.
Lift by Robert Cabas. He's got the bronze medal. Australia's first first weightlifting medal since 1952. The competition is still alive, but no one could possibly take that away from him now. But can he win the silver?
I think he's got a bit more left in him. That's a very good clean. He's pulled the bar high. Bounces at the bottom, but recovers strongly on his legs, and it's important that your leg power is up, and his seems to be on tonight, and the jerk gives him no trouble whatsoever. Great lift.
Superb lifting by Robert Cabas. He's up with the pace setters.
The Australian camp look very happy.
A real battle of tactics here now in the fight for the silver medal between Isayoka of Japan and Robert Cabas of Australia. Cabas leads by 2.5 kilos. He successfully lifted 192.5 kilos. Isayoka has chosen to pass that weight. And so Cabas comes out at 195 kilos. Now, if he was to lift this weight, that would give him a break of 7.5 kilos on the Japanese lifter. Sorry, 5 kilos on the Japanese lifter, which would certainly put the pre-competition favourite under immense pressure. Cabas has the bronze medal. There is no doubt about that.
The only real little problem is that Isayoka is a lighter man. So should they level on total, then Isayoka would win because of his lighter body weight.
But gee, this has been a courageous performance by Cabas. The Australian camp has had to think this event through very carefully. As we've said, it's a battle of tactics as well as a battle of strength.
This will re-break the Australian record he just set and will also be a total record.
He's determined. He's already set records, as Bob just told you.
Tremendous clean.
He's going to give this a shake.
He's getting himself set.
Just beyond him. But he's still placed to win the silver medal because he leads Isayoka by 2.5 kilos. Now, Isayoka has two lifts left with which to beat Cabas. But what a great performance by Robert Cabas. Despite this failure with his final lift in the competition, he's won the bronze medal. And he's broken national records as well.
It's a tremendous performance.
Isayoka of Japan. He's put the weight up to 200 kilos. If he's successful, he nudges Cabas out of the silver medal. If he fails, he's got one lift left with which to relieve that medal from Cabas.
It's interesting that he should choose 200 kilos because he could have taken 197, so he must be feeling confident.
Well, he's obviously going to try and throw out some sort of a threat to... Oh, he's missed it! Isayoka has missed it! He's under pressure now. He's under some real pressure. He's got one lift left, with which to clear 200 kilos. He can't go down. And if he doesn't, Kabas gets the silver.
That's a tactical error from the Japanese camp, taking 200 kilos.
This is the competition leader, Beșaru of Romania. He's going to make his final lift in the competition at 200 kilos. That's all he needs to secure the gold medal. It's only a formality, not so much the lift, but securing the gold medal. Beșaru of Romania, he's dominated this event. It's the light heavyweight division, 82.5 kilos. This is the first time we've seen him struggle.
He didn't struggle with
his capabilities. The gold medalist in the 82.5 kilo division.
What a tremendous lift.
Beșaru from Romania. He had complete control of the situation throughout the competition. And that was a very strong performance by him.
This lift is no harder than any of the other ones he's done. Perhaps he took a little bit longer to get up with the queen. But the jerk was very easy. And the crowd are going wild.
Now what a thrilling climax this 82.5 kilo division has come to. This is Isayoka of Japan. He has one lift left in the competition. He's already missed at 200 kilos. He's decided to put it up to 207.5 kilos.
This is incredible. If he gets this, it will be a gold medal for him.
If he misses, it'll be a bronze medal and Kabas will get the silver. The Japanese camp has taken a real gamble here, and that could be to Australia's benefit. It could also be a gold strike for Japan. My word, what a courageous effort this is going to be. What a courageous decision.
His best lift is 205, so this is 2.5 kilos above it, and he missed 200 earlier.
This is a real gamble, but this is when weightlifting becomes intriguing. This little game of mental gymnastics that's been going on for the last 30 or 40 minutes out in the warm-up room now reaches its climax. Isayoka of Japan with the bar at 207.5 kilos. If he's successful, he wins the gold medal. If he's unsuccessful, he wins the bronze. And Robert Kabas of Australia gets the silver. At worst, Kabas can finish up with a bronze medal.
Tremendous pressure on Isayoka at this time.
This is the most exciting weightlifting competition we've seen so far. Oh, he's under pressure. He's under pressure.
What a tremendous clean.
That was raw courage. The Japanese call for silence, and he's missed it. Isayoka has missed it. It's gold to Beșaru. It's a silver medal to Robert Kabas of Australia. Australia's first weightlifting medal since Helsinki in 1952. When Vern Barbaros was successful. That's a tragedy for Isayoka of Japan, a personal tragedy, but a great result for Australia. Barbaros, of course, back in 1952 won a bronze, so it's Australia's best ever result in the weightlifting tournament. There you see the final attempt from Isayoka of Japan. He needed this to win the gold medal. He missed it, and so has to be content with the bronze, silver to Kabas of Australia, and the gold to Beșaru.
There's Robert Kabas of Australia picking up the silver. First silver medal we've ever won in weightlifting in Olympic history. And Isayoka of Japan picking up the bronze. Two other track events.